स्टार्ट सर।
Okay. Yeah. Good afternoon again. So I think there was a disruption. So and I think there is still a problem with the video. So I'll continue without the video. So I think we were discussing regarding why transform is required. So let me continue from there on the. So what we have understood that yes, there is a series that was a representation in the frequency domain. And then from there, we for any signal, non-periodic also, can be represented in frequency domain by the method of transform. So this is something we have already done in the class. Okay. Now, once we have got this transform representation, then we know that there is additional representation of the signal, same signal. In time domain, it can be represented. It can be also represented in the frequency domain. And now the question is, why do we require this? This additional representation, does it give us any facility? So let us try to see one example, which is that modulation. Somebody has also asked why this linear CW modulation is, what is it and why it is required. So we'll come to that. What is linear CW modulation, continuous wave modulation? So that's something we'll talk about later. But right now, let's try to see what modulation does actually. So first thing that modulation actually does is we had a requirement that the same media, let's say the air media, we want to use it for multiple transmission, simultaneous transmission. Now, if whatever we are talking, we just transmit in the air, if we do that, or we are anywhere. Hello. Hello.
Hi, sir.
Is it still on?
Hi, sir. On ache apni start korun, sir.
Okay. So, yeah, there was another disruption probably. So we'll continue from what we were discussing. So basically what we were saying that once we do this modulation, so why we need this modulation, let's try to understand that. whenever we do a modulation, what happens, this modulation is required because we want to actually reuse a particular media for multiple transmission, or simultaneously we want to multiplex simultaneous transmission through that media, and at the receiver we should be able to select whichever we want to select. So this was our intention. So if we wish to do that, then somehow they cannot be superimposed. If we just all those time domain signal, we just blindly transmit, then they'll all get superimposed and we won't be able to discriminate them at the receiver. And we'll be getting a jumbled up signal. So the information will be lost. So for that to be happening, so what we have seen is, if a signal is multiplied by cos omega ct, let's say, okay, with some frequency omega c, it's a little higher frequency probably. If we do that, then immediately what we see is, in the frequency domain, the entire spectrum gets translated to a particular higher frequency. So if it was earlier sitting around zero, now it will be sitting around omega c with the same omega c and minus omega c. Of course, the spectrums are symmetric. So this will be happening. So if we just do modulation, then at a particular frequency, we can bring them. Like this, suppose we choose two different frequencies, omega c1 and omega c2, which has enough separation, and then we modulate two signals, then what will happen? In the time domain, they might be mixed, but in the frequency domain, they will have a separate place if we can choose our omega c1 and omega c2 correctly. Okay, so if that happens, then immediately what will happen? They will be sitting separately in the frequency domain. Time domain, they might get mixed up. Frequency domain, they'll be sitting separately. So this is the beauty of modulation. Now at the receiver, what you can do, you can do a frequency domain processing, which is called a bandpass filtering. Okay. So bandpass filtering means it passes some of the frequency component and rejects all other frequency components. So suppose I am interested in the first signal, which is modulated at omega C1. So around omega C1, I will put a bandwidth of B, which is the message bandwidth actually. So then what will happen, it will just pass that signal and it will suppress all other signals. Then the receiver will be able to detect that signal. So this is the advantage we'll get if we see it from the frequency domain. So now you can see this modulation is one of the things which does at the transmitter end, which does a frequency domain's translation. So this is what we are trying to do over here. And at the receiver, we do another frequency domain processing, which is a bandpass filtering. So that exactly gives us facility of reusing the same channel for multiplexing multiple, means parallel data or multiple parallel signals. And at the receiver, we can separate them out just by doing this frequency domain processing. So a frequency domain representation is, that is why it is so important, because there are other representation which can facilitate us other kind of signal processing or other kind of representation of the signal, so that we get our desired outcome. I hope this is a little bit clear to everybody. Now, let us go back to some other question that people have probably posted. So one is this continuous wave means modulation. Why that is, or linear continuous wave modulation, why that is required. So all this amplitude modulation, DSBSC, SSBSC, vestigial sideband, these are all kind of linear continuous wave modulation. So basically what we are doing over here, we are carrying our information over the amplitude of a carrier. And that carrier is the continuous wave thing. Okay, so it's a continuous wave. Carrier is actually a sinusoidal, which is continuously on. And that's the part of the carrier. It is carrying some information. And what we are doing, we are multiplying these two signals. If you just take DSBSC, so it's a multiplication of two signals. Or if you take amplitude modulation, then the carrier will be added to the multiplication. Okay, so this kind of stuff which are happening, and this particular thing are all kind of linear operation. So as we are doing this linear operation, so we can always say it's a linear continuous wave modulation that we are trying to do. Why it is important, we have already talked about that. So that is why it's very important that we actually do this linear continuous wave modulation. So modulation is required for one, this purpose. Second, there is also another purpose which is related to the antenna theory actually. So basically, as if you wish to transmit the baseband signal, which is centered around zero, suppose my voice call, I equivalently means generate the frequency, a time domain signal, electrical signal, then it will be occupying from 300 hertz to at most 3.3 kilohertz. Okay, so 3.3 kilohertz or 300 hertz, that's a very small frequency. And if you really see the wavelength will be very high, because wavelength is inversely proportional to the frequency. And then if you really wish to capture it through our antenna, the antenna size generally has to be almost of the same order of the wavelength. So the antenna size will become very big. So think about the scenario where your mobile phone is carrying a huge horn antenna or something like that. So that's not a good thing, comes smaller. And the antenna size will be much smaller, which can fit very nicely. And that gives up good design. So this is from the system design perspective, we require for this course. Okay, so as you can see, the mathematical tools which are required, this course doesn't require a prerequisite the way I have taught it. So basically the mathematical tools which are required, like Fourier series, Fourier transform, and probably later on you'll see probability theory and application of that in random process and all kinds of things. So all those things I'll be covering them. So you just need to be proficient in those two things. Okay, so if you are proficient in those two things, and you can do basic math like integration, differential equation solving, and those kind of things, and basic algebra, you are good at it. Okay, so there's no problem in that. So that's the overall mathematical things you'll be requiring. And then there was some administrative question. One was telling that we need some tutorial. That's a good suggestion, probably. We might not be having tutorial over here in this course, the way we conduct this course. It doesn't have the tutorial part, but that can be something that can be taken up in future. So that we have a tutorial where we can actually engage some TAs to facilitate you to solve some problem. So I have tried to solve few problems so that you know the pattern. But what I have emphasized in my course is basically giving you all the basic knowledge so that you can solve any of the things. Once you have a good basic understanding of the entire mathematical tools as well as the physical understanding of the whole system, then probably any question that is being thrown at you, you will be able to tackle them. So that was the hope. And probably if that is not still working, probably we can think about some alternative, that putting tutorial into it. So that might be another option. Of course, TAs are always there. You have a discussion forum. You can ask question regarding, of course, you don't ask them to solve the assignment problem. That's for you to solve. But you can always ask things just to get clarification. I'll be also available if you need. The TA will percolate it to me, and I can answer them as well. So that's another means to answer your question. And there was another administrative question that we need lecture notes. That's something being prepared. I hope that is being distributed also by the TAs in this particular year. Earlier it was not available. Now we have a transcript, and we are also preparing the PDF version of it with all the equations embedded. So that's also being solved, I hope, for everybody. So, yeah, I do not see any other questions. So probably that's where I'll end my session. And we'll see if some more sessions later on can be done. There was some disruption today. So, yeah, but that's part and parcel of these days teaching, probably, because it's online mode. Okay, thank you.